Are you sure?
I'm sure.
This therapist, and we're trying to get into the mind of this young boy who's in a schizophrenic coma. And what happens is there's a serial killer out there. They come to me and the rest of the people on this project to see if we can get inside his mind, because he happens to be in the same comatose state that this boy is in. And they ask her if there's any way that she can go into his mind to help find his last victim. They come to her almost as a last resort, like, we need something. There's nothing else we can do, and this girl's gonna drown in 36 hours. Tarsem, the director, he was such a visual director. He had such an idea of what these bizarre images that he wanted to put in there, and kind of going inside the mind of a killer and what that would look like and what it would be like. First, I'm in this like little boy's mind. It's like all fairy tales and beautiful deserts and costumes. The next thing, I drop into the mind of this killer, and it's like the images are so surreal and in a way beautiful but disgusting. And so it's really an interesting movie because there were no limits. I just remember, like, even the costumes, putting them on and going, what are we doing right now? Like, who am I right now? He's like, we're inside the mind of the killer. And I was like, okay, great. Just trying to make everything feel authentic and real. Thing about Tarsem, he knows exactly what he wants in every single frame. Sometimes he's like, this is what I want you to do, which I love. That's what you want from a director, direction, and knowing that this is the vision they have, and they're gonna help you get there whatever way you can. When there's nothing there, if you're working with blue screen, or the actors are not there because they have this elaborate makeup, and he's like, okay, you know, Vince will be saying to you this, I'm on a close-up of your face, I need you to cry. You know, I'm like, okay.
So hard, where you're just saying, well, stand up here, I know there's nothing in front of you, but now imagine there's a really vast space. There's only so many that you can do before, you know, it gets boring. You have to be as trusting as you can be to the person who's telling you the visuals. And she was very.
So was that one for me. And it was actually a script I had read earlier in my career when I was like doing television. And then when I was doing the album, I had a meeting with New Line and Mike DeLuca. I said, you know, you have this movie here that I found out you guys have. It's called The Cell. And I don't want to. He's like, oh, you want to do that? All right, let's do it. Let's find the director. And we kind of went from there. And of course, being on a movie from that early on, instead of like going in and auditioning when the project's all set up, is a very much different process. Because from the time Mike and I had that meeting to the time we started principal photography, it was almost a year later. As an artist, you have something creatively to put forth and you want to be taken seriously. And if you're part of the project from its inception, from the thought of it, then you have a perspective, you have an opinion about the way things should be, and people are more ready to listen to you. And that's very satisfying as an artist.
The Cell is such a dope movie.
Yeah, I mean, Tarsem is a real
incredible.
Visionary. Yeah, he's an amazing
director.
And that
movie still really holds up, so even the effects and everything.
Yeah.
When Vincent D'Onofrio is coming down, he first sees you and you turn around and press the little button.
No, it's crazy.
It's still
chilling.
Like, oh my God.
It's chilling. And to be caught in that world, again, it's like creating these worlds where people, their imagination goes wild.
Where you come from?
that's the great thing about acting is that I'm able to get into the mindset of the characters that I play, you know. With this woman, she's very driven. She's almost a sacrificial lamb. You'll see as she goes into the mind of this boy and into the mind of this killer, it's like it's taking a toll on her, but it's like almost doesn't matter. She's almost a savior type person and gives so much to other people where you almost sacrifice yourself. It's not a healthy thing, but it's a mindset that is interesting to go into. And with all the characters I play, I always try to get into the core of why they do things. It was a project that I was very passionate about. And like with everything I do, you know, I see it from beginning to end.